Hello and welcome to My Digital Quill. There's no question that having a control checklist or a to-do list for an ongoing activity or project is a great way to execute things in order. But a dynamic to-do list crosses off your done task from the list just on a single click. Let us walk you through on how to create one for yourself. We'll start off by going to the ribbon menu system above. On the right click of the mouse, we'll open the menu to customize the ribbon. And once we are in the Excel options, over to our right is where the options for all the tabs are available. As you can see, the only options unchecked is Draw and Developer. So I'm going to check this Developer option and press OK. Now you see the Developer tab is available for us. Without delaying any further, we'll go in Developer tab and go to Controls group in here and go to Insert, Form Control Options. We'll take Checkbox from here and bring it to our Status column. And I'm going to carve out a checkbox in here. I'm going to leave the caption there. I think it makes a good impact. You can take it off if you don't think so. Once we have our checkbox in place, we'll simply select the cell and drag this down for multiple checkboxes in our list. If you need to add simple checkboxes, but you don't want to do anything with the results of the checkbox aside from seeing the check marks visually, then you're done. But if you want to get to, as I call it, a dynamic checklist, then you go to the checkbox and right click to form control. In the window in here, we see unchecked, check, and mixed options in here. Now, these options are subjected to your click on the box. But more important to us is a cell link here. This editing panel is where you can assign cells for the results of the checkbox. How does that work? Well, we'll just assign the cell right here, press Enter, and now press OK. Now, as you can see, once a checkbox is clicked, it's showing us true. Once it's unchecked, it's showing us false. Now, this is the information I can use to control anything else. I can make use of this simple switch and mix it with conditional formatting. So I go to Format Control. Now I want my results to appear in the same cell where my checkbox is at. So I'm gonna do this D4 instead of F4. And take off those dollar signs. And we're gonna do the same thing for each one of these checkboxes. So D5 and D6. And D7 for this. D8 for this. And D9, of course. I press OK. Now you see, when I press the checkbox, it's saying true, uncheck, false. Don't worry about the overwriting. I'll just use white color to make it visually go away. But Excel knows that true and false option is appearing in the cell, even though it's visually not appearing. Since we have all our true and false switches appearing in the checkbox cells, we can get rid of the previous one where the results were appearing. Okay, so now we'll use the result to adjust the formatting. So every time I have a checkbox checked and the result displaying true in the white font, I want to have a strike through kind of formatting for my list item. That's conditional formatting. So I highlight all my items in the outstanding activities column and go to conditional formatting. In here, we go to new rule, and the rule is to use a formula. That formula will utilize this cell where true or false is appearing. And we have to be a little careful here. We want the dollar sign to stay on the D, but not 4, because we want the column to be same, but the rows to be dynamic. So we hit the format. And we want the format of the checked item to be on the grayscale, and we want it to have strike through kind of format. So that adjusted, we click OK, and now it's all good. You see, every time you press check mark on it, it will display gray font with the strike through on it. Now, in addition to this, you can also make use of a list from this list of the actions not done in here. Let's say if I want to use this space for the other list, and I'm going to use filter function for that. The area would be my outstanding activities, and it's asking me what to include in the next argument. I'm going to include status column in here, and anything in here be equal to false. I'm going to include that in my argument. And if you remember, anything that is unchecked is basically that is false. So as I'm going to press enter, the whole list will appear here, that is in here, because these all are unchecked. So as I'm checking this off, my other list is reducing. If you found this piece informative, please encourage us by giving us a thumbs up. But don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this.